Are there any particular political parties or political philosophies that you support?
Well, I sometimes call myself a libertarian, but that's only because most people don't know what anarchist means. Most people think if you say you're an anarchist, it means you're getting ready to throw a bomb at a building. They don't understand the concept of voluntary association or the whole concept of replacing force with voluntary cooperation, contractual arrangements, and so on. So libertarian is a clearer word. It doesn't arouse so much immediate anxiety on the part of the listener. And then again, libertarians, if they were totally consistent with their principles, would be anarchists. They take the position which they call minarchy, which is the smallest possible government. That's a very Jeffersonian idea. The reason I don't believe in the smallest possible government is because we started out with that, and it only took us 200 years to arrive at the czarist occupation government that we got now. I think any government is dangerous, no matter how small you make it. It should be, instead of governments, we should have contractual associations, which you can opt out of if you don't like the way the association is going. Like religions fought for hundreds of years over which religion should dominate Europe, and then they finally gave up and made a truce. And they all agree to tolerate one another, at least in this part of the world. Well, Americans aren't so sure about tolerating Islam right now, are they? But by and large, I think government should be treated like religion. Everybody should pick the kind they like. Only it should be contractual, not obligatory. I wouldn't mind paying tax money to a local association to maintain a police force, as long as we need one. But I hate like hell paying taxes to help the United States government build more nuclear missiles to blow up more people I don't even know, but I don't think I would hate them if I did know them. A lot of anarchists had a major role in influencing my political thinking, especially the individualist anarchists, and Benjamin Tucker and Lysander Spooner especially. But I've also been influenced by Leo Tolstoy's anarcho-pacifism. And I find a lot of Kropotkin quite compatible, too, even though he was a communist anarchist. Nothing wrong with communist anarchism as long as it remains voluntary. Anybody who wants to join together and make a commune, go ahead, do it. I got nothing against it. As long as there's room for the individualist, too, to do his own thing or her own thing, as the case may be, or its own thing. I'm in favor of freedom for dogs, too.